Sir, I crave your indulgence for the time. I have many things to speak on this. And before passing this legislation, the House government must take note of it. So I crave your indulgence. Basically, this bill is empowering RBI to give direction to the banks to invoke the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code on the loan defaulters. In these loan defaulters has been given a respectable name called non-performing asset to begin with, and thereafter it has been given non-stressed asset, thereafter given non-cooperative borrower. Those who are pilfering bank money in the name of for the investment, those who are pilfering bank money, these are all public money, you are giving them a respectable name. Secondly, day in and day out, your CEO of Niti Aayog, every day, the manner he has been vomiting in the media, everything should be privatized. Everything should be privatized. In this context, any action you are taking about bank is fraught with many apprehension that what is your real intention. And this apprehension got further substantiated by a similar vomiting by the Deputy Governor of the Reserve Bank of India by giving a clarion call that the banks should be reprivatized. So, in this background, I think before passing this bill, the duty of the government to clarify these apprehensions. This empowers the bank, that through Reserve Bank of India, to invoke action against the defaulters. It is an welcome step. And in this respect, I think only one occasion I have an occasion to agree to the statement just made by Honorable Finance Minister that yes, it is already late that we are taking action. This is being done, this is being talked about in this house of regularly mounting NPA, demanding action, and now Honorable Minister is telling that we are late in taking action, so this bill should be passed. I agree, this bill should be passed. And I also agree you are late in taking action. But the manner in the context of which you are taking action, that is raising apprehension. You have already, through Reserve Bank, made a public statement that banks should go for a haircut to address the NPA. What is haircut? Means writing off. Already a good amount has been written off. Whose money? People's money in bank. How do you write off? A good amount has been written off. Some 3 lakh crore. How do you write off? And your deputy governor is promoting the idea of haircut. Then you brought another bill. Now it is being prepared. Financial Resolution and Deposit Insurance Bill, FRDI bill, which has been conceived with sweeping arbitrary power to a resolution board constituted under that bill to liquidate the banks. So FRDI bill is being brought, structured to liquidate the banking, banks under loss. At the same time, Reserve Bank Deputy Governor every day talking everything should be reprivatized. And at the same time, you are suggesting a haircut. That is, give away the loans. And many people are involved in that. So in this background, how this action is going to be effective, that is to be considered. And to keep this non-effective, intentionally, you are giving the empowering the banks through Reserve Bank of India to recover the loans through Insolvency Bankruptcy Code in a manner so that bank need not be held accountable. Why RBI is in between? It is the banks who are suffering from loan default. Some people took money, is not paying back. It is the banks who are suffering from loan default. If they are to recover the money, they have been given an instrument. Fine, welcome. Now, for application of that instrument, whether banks are properly applying that instrument, how do you hold bank accountable if they are to act as per the direction of RBI? And what is the attitude and approach? Already only name of the 12 companies came in the public domain. That against whom the action to be taken, only 12 companies. What is the amount involved? 2.53 lakh crore. It is less than 25% of the total estimated NPA, which government is also agreeing to. Which government is also agreeing to that amount. It is hardly 25%. And number of times it has been talked about by government that hardly the problem of NPA remains. 70-80% of the NPA are limited within 50 companies. These 50 companies cannot be straightened. The sovereign government of India is having sovereign power. They could not take appropriate action against 50 companies, only 50 borrowers. And they are who's who? They are accompanying our minister in their foreign trip. And this foreign trip is facilitating contract with those private companies in the for with Israel or the different other countries. And this is the thing, please.
I am just reminding you.
Oh, okay, thank you.
We have a constraint of time.
I am trying to become as brief as possible.
Please be brief.
So what I feel that these apprehensions government must be clear. Must clear. And privatization cannot be a solution. I like to draw the attention of the House and also government to another fact. The government, the banking system, many other public sector companies is being targeted for privatization. Honorable Minister told, power sector is also suffering because of this NPA. Other, but kindly note, steel minister is sitting over here. The steel sector is facing a severe crisis. But none of the public sector steel company has yet defaulted in their obligation to service the loan taken from the bank. Honorable Steel Minister should confirm. SAIL is bleeding after 4,000 crore loss, but they have not defaulted their obligation on loan debt servicing to the nationalized bank. Air India, you are targeting for a privatization. Yes, they are under severe soup. But even then, they have not defaulted even for a single day in repaying their loan debt servicing to the banks. But you are targeting them from wholesale privatization. And through FRDI bill, the apprehension is that with that liquidation power, today you are empowering the bank to invoke insolvency and bankruptcy code on the loan debtor company. And tomorrow, FRDI bill will empower the government to invoke insolvency and bankruptcy code on the banking companies also, including the Nationalist Bank. What is your plan? What is your program? That raises a doubt, that raises the apprehension, that creates a problem of credibility. I think this step, empowering the bank, I welcome. My suggestion is, please take out RBI from the picture. RBI is a regulator. They are not service provider. It is a government-owned bank. Government must direct. And banks should be directly empowered to invoke IBC, Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code. And if they don't invoke, their board can be held accountable. Only in this process, a quick recovery is possible. In between, if you keep another agency which is loaded with different ideas targeted to privatization, even this project will not meet a minimum success. I can tell you in advance, at least that is my understanding of the thing. So my suggestion is that, and accordingly, my colleague T.K. Ranganathan has moved amendments also, that it should be, they should be directly empowered, and Reserve Bank of India's role, they can supervise, they can regulate, but they cannot direct. They cannot select the companies. The responsibility of select the companies against whom insolvency and bankruptcy code is to be invoked has to be decided by the board of directors of the bank, and then only accountability can be established and the process can be quickened up. Otherwise not. Otherwise it will be only 12 companies and another 38 companies will be let free, and they will be given the facility of haircut. And in the final analysis, finally these banks will be handed over in the through privatization to the hands of the same crooks who have pilfered the bank money and make our banking system bleeding. My humble request to the Honourable Minister, kindly consider this position. I welcome that banks should be empowered. To that extent, this ordinance as well as bill has made facilitated that arrangement, but partially with a defect, made bank directly responsible, directly accountable, empower them to invoke insolvency and bankruptcy court on those debtors who are making the bank bleeding. Sir, those who are now responsible for the NPA, those 50 companies, kindly take note, kindly scrutinize. You are not bringing them in public domain. You have a political problem, I understand. But the fact is that in the company, big companies having multiple businesses, one company is suffering with NPA, while other companies are still enjoying loan from the banking system, still taking loan from the banking system.
Mr. Sen, please conclude now. Please conclude.
Just conclude.
Please conclude.
Just conclude. Kindly.
Cabinet Minister and the two MOSs, none of them are present. The two MOSs and one Cabinet Minister.
They're taking notes. I mean, other Cabinet Ministers are there and he's taking notes.
Two Honourable MOSs, Chair, not one present.
Honourable Chair, the Finance Minister is in the other House.
Please conclude, Mr. Please conclude, Mr. Sen.
You are noting with concern about what all you are saying, and you are not noting that what you are noting.
So my suggestion is that make those name of the 50 borrowers on the public domain. While government will be exercising monitor,
thank you.
People should also allow to monitor the situation,
right,
and directly empower the banks. Don't keep FBI, RBI in between. Let the government or the ministry direct the bank, and accordingly bank board are made responsible. And in the bank board, your ministry's representative also remains. Bank's board is made directly responsible to invoke IBC, Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code, on the loan defaulters. With that, we'll only quicken up the process of recovery, at least to some extent, the people's money deposited in the bank, and treat the crook a lesson.
Thank you.
Only request. Kindly, I urge upon you to accept my amendments on that issue.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Sen.